It was meant to be an olive branch, but the Queen's invitation to Sarah, Duchess of York, to join the royal family during their annual summer retreat at Balmoral has turned into a right royal disaster. New Idea has learned that the weekend turned to chaos as an explosive row erupted between Fergie and Camilla, Duchess of Cornwall. Fergie and Camilla came to blows at Balmoral last week. It was an enormous row that absolutely no one saw coming, a palace source tells New Idea. According to insiders, the Queen had invited the disgraced former wife of Prince Andrew to Scotland ahead of her daughter Princess Eugenie's wedding in the hope that all the family could get used to the Duchess being back in the royal fold. But despite the Queen putting her differences with her former daughter-in-law Sarah aside, she wasn't counting on the Duchess of Cornwall and Fergie brawling after a build-up of over 20 years of simmering tensions. It seems that Fergie has never really confronted Camilla over the pain and heartache she caused Diana over her affair with Charles, explains the royal source. Fergie and Diana were close friends and she saw firsthand the anxiety and depression that opening bracket Camilla and Charles closing bracket affair brought to her, and it's always churned away inside Fergie. Despite Diana and Fergie falling out towards the end of the princess' life, the pair were extremely close at one point, a fact which the Duchess of York has never forgotten. "Diana was one of the wits I knew. Nobody made me laugh like her," she gushed in an interview with Harper's Bazaar. In fact, Princess Diana was instrumental in orchestrating the romance between Sarah Ferguson and Prince Andrew, with Diana taking the chance to matchmake by inviting her future sister-in-law to a party at Windsor Castle back in 1985. So the fact that Fergie would want to defend Diana over Camilla comes as no surprise. Just 1 year after Diana had set up Fergie and Andrew, Prince Charles began secretly seeing Camilla behind his unsuspecting young wife's back. Diana was also busy looking after their two young sons. And now, in the run-up to the 21st anniversary of Diana's tragic death, Fergie has finally let rip at Camilla. "Fergie couldn't hold it in anymore and really let Camilla have it during after-dinner drinks at Balmoral," continues the source. "She and Camilla have never seen eye to eye, but being at Balmoral brought back a lot of memories of Diana and all the time they spent there together, so it was only a matter of time before she let Camilla have it. They really went at it." Fergie didn't hold back and told Camilla she had Diana's blood on her hands for all the pain she caused. No one really knew where to look. It was a fight that no one's seen before within palace walls. Camilla, Duchess of Cornwall, will become queen despite Clarence House's previously claiming she will not take the title when her husband is crowned, a former private secretary said. When Camilla married Prince Charles in 2005, the royal palace issued a statement saying the Prince of Wales's second wife would not use the title of Queen Consort out of deference to late Princess Diana. But a royal insider believes the chances of seeing a Queen Camilla are high. Patrick Jefferson, private secretary to Diana, the Princess of Wales, between 1989 and 1996. Shared his views on what the future holds for the Duchess of Cornwall. Appearing on Channel 4's The Royal House of Windsor, he said, "I think Queen Camilla was always on the cards. You'll never find it acknowledged. You'll find clever wording like there are no plans or it is not envisaged. But I bet you a dollar to a donut Her Majesty Queen Camilla will be crowned." Mr. Jeffson's shocking claim came shortly before Clarence House removed any references to the potential title the Duchess will use once her husband and heir will ascend to the throne. Last year, the royal's official website stated in its Frequently Asked Questions page, "Will the Duchess become queen when the prince becomes king?" As was explained at the time of their wedding in April 2005. It is intended that the Duchess will be known as HRH, the Prince's consort, when the Prince of Wales acceded to the throne. Clarence House officials said the statement was removed because the public was no longer interested in the issue. Prince Charles and Camilla had a years-long affair while the Prince of Wales was still married to Diana. The affair was made public by the princess in 1995. During a bombshell interview to Panorama where Diana unveiled the deepest secrets of her unhappy marriage, famously saying there were three people in her relationship with Charles. Following Diana's death in 1997, Prince Charles made clear within the palace his relationship with Camilla was non-negotiable. And it was officially revealed 2 years later, on January 29, 1999, when the pair was seen leaving London's Ritz Hotel together. Mr. Jeffson's belief there will be a Queen Camilla is already proven correct by the British Constitution, which states the wife of the king automatically becomes a queen consort. Royal expert James Brooks had previously told Express.co.uk, Camilla will become queen, there is no choice to make. Only a direct intervention of the government in the royal matter would prevent this from happening. But a change in the constitution for a similar reason may upset many, Mr. Brooks said. The expert continued, despite the public opinion started to change over the years, many are still very skeptical about Camilla, a lot of people are antagonistic towards her and that's mainly down to the relationship and previous history with Diana. But while her becoming queen could enrage some, a change in the constitution just for Camilla may get even more people very upset. Meghan Markle, 37, and Prince Harry, 33, had their wedding in May. Now is it claimed Princess Eugenie, 28, and Jack Brooksbank, 32, are planning a wedding that is even bigger than theirs. Princess Eugenie and Jack Brooksbank are planning a festival-style event for their wedding. The minor royals' plans involve celebrating with guests over a whole weekend. While their ceremony would take place on Friday, the couple and their family and friends will continue the celebrations all weekend. Another party will take place on Saturday afternoon. According to reports from people, the couple will have a party on Saturday in the grounds of the Royal Lodge. The grand building was Eugenie's childhood home and Prince Andrew, 58, still owns the property. Eugenie's wedding weekend will certainly be jam-packed with events. The couple will marry on Friday in the early afternoon. They will then have a lunch hosted by the Queen at Windsor Castle, much like Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's first reception. Then the couple will go on to have a black tie evening reception at the Royal Lodge. If guests aren't exhausted and too hungover, they can also attend another party the next day, where there will be a fairground and different food stalls. A source told People, it is Eugenie and Jack's party and they are very much involved in all the details and decisions. The magazine also reports that Bentley's Entertainment is organizing Saturday's event. The Beckhams also hired this company for their wedding in 1999. Couple Princess Eugenie be copying Meghan Markle's wedding look. For her wedding to Prince Harry in May, Meghan opted for minimal makeup with all attention on her long, luscious eyelashes. But those lashes weren't the Duchess' real lashes, they were, in fact, eyelash extensions. Hannah Puciato, founder of London Lash, predicts that Eugenie will also sport the same stunning look for her nuptials. Talking to TheExpress.co.uk, Hannah said, the best eyelash look for Princess Eugenie is squirrel, or kitten, effect. This elegant style will enhance her eyes, making them even more beautiful. Princess Eugenie reveals plans to follow in Sarah Ferguson's footsteps after her wedding. Princess Eugenie. Five facts about Prince Andrew and Sarah Ferguson's youngest daughter. Full name. Her full title is Princess Eugenie Victoria Helena of York. She is the Queen's sixth grandchild and is currently ninth in the line of succession. Education. Eugenie started her education at Wingfield Montessori before heading to Upton House School and Coworth Park School. She then attended St. George's School in Windsor before completing her levels in Art, English Literature, and History of Art at Marlborough College. To undertake her bachelor's degree in English Literature, History of Art and Politics, Eugenie attended Newcastle University. Career. In 2013, Eugenie moved to New York City to work for online auction firm Padelade as a benefit auctions manager. She returned to London in 2015 to work for Hauser & Worth Art Gallery as an associate director, gaining a promotion to be a director in 2017. Social media princess Eugenie joined Instagram in March this year, the first royal to officially do so. Other members of the royal family have accounts run by the palaces. She has 281,000 followers, but is only following 19 accounts, including close friend Ellie Goulding, her mother, and Queen Rania of Jordan. Celebrity friends: Eugenie mixes in strictly A-list circles and is friends with celebrities and the cream of British society. Close girlfriends include Cressida Bonas and Shilzi Davy, both former flames of Prince Harry. Ellie Goulding, Carita Leving, Jack Whitehall, Jimmy Carr, and James Blunt are also known to be friendly with the princess. Wow.